Good evening. I'm Holly Peter Schaefer. I'm an attorney at Ramsey McDonald. I always like to tell people I actually have an engineering degree undergrad. I just don't really use it for much in what I do on a daily basis. So I'm looking at the legal aspects of putting the bid together and what are the ramifications of that and what does that mean once you submit it. We have 10 minutes. I typically give a presentation on this for an hour and a half. So I'm going to go quickly, and if you have questions, you can ask them at the end, and I'm sure you will. Okay, so the biggest and most important thing that I always want to make sure everybody does when they get a bid document, whether it's an RFP, it's a hard bid document, invitation to bid, whatever it is, read it. Read what the requirements are. How long are you going to have to hold that bid open for? Are you making sure you're getting that from your lower tiers? If you have suppliers below you that you're purchasing items for, you need to know how long that bid is open for, and we'll get to why that is important. What's the bid opening time frame? Is the owner going to open them immediately at the time that the bids are due? Are they going to wait 30 days and let you know? You need to know this. There's a reason why you need to know this, and we will get to that later as well. Okay, contract. I think more contractors, engineers, architects, and especially clients are getting more sophisticated in terms of what they're buying in construction. I think the reason for that is we have a smaller group of contractors, subcontractors, suppliers, and owners, especially after 2008. So they know what they're buying. They're sophisticated buyers. They are putting their contracts and their bid terms inside of their bid documents. If you submit a bid, you don't include qualifications, you don't include any exceptions inside of your bid, you are likely agreeing to those terms. You need to read what those terms are. What are they going to be required to do? Does it cost money? Because you have a longer warranty period than 1 year, that's typical. What if it's 18 months? What if it starts after final completion versus substantial completion? What is your insurance going to look like? You need to know, because everything you do inside that contract and what you're agreeing to has a cost factor to it.